As President Marcos's former executive secretary has been expelled from their political party, the Philippine Federal Party accused Vic Rodriguez of betrayal and committing acts inimical to the group. Party officials complained about the alleged role of Rodriguez in supposedly questionable appointments of several government officials. He also allegedly blocked applications submitted by party members to his office. The party also took issue with other controversies Rodriguez faced while he was part of the Marcos administration. Rodriguez says he is unbothered by his expulsion.
Yung doon sa ginawa nilang desisyon, wala naman sa akin yun. Hindi naman kawalan. As I was all set to leave the party as early as even earlier than October 18. The reason why they took me out of the party is apparently because of my disloyalty. How they arrive at that? Simply because hindi na-appoint o hindi nila nakuha yung mga posisyon na kanilang hinihiling noong ako ay naroon pa. Kung hindi naman qualified yung humihingi ng appointment, bakit ko naman susugan yung kanilang application for the appointment? At hindi maliliit na pwesto ito.
Rodriguez served as the Federal Party's Executive Vice President. The party's chairman, President Marcos, is said to have taken no part in the expulsion but offered no objection to the move. Rodriguez resigned as the president's executive secretary in September, citing family reasons. And the confirmation of Philippine Social Welfare Secretary Erwin Tulfo deferred by the Commission on Appointments after lawmakers questioned his supposed U.S. citizenship and his previous libel convictions. Sherian Torres has more.
Philippine Social Welfare Secretary Erwin Tulfo faced rough sailing before the Commission on Appointments. Surigao del Sur Congressman Johnny Pimentel questioned Tulfo about his past relationships. Tulfo has 10 children from 4 women.
We're separated, Your Honor, Mr. Chair. Yes, we're in good terms. We're in talking terms, and including all my children. Some of them are in the United States, and some are here.
But Pimentel sees a potential conflict given Tulfo's high public position.
Considering that in your line of work, the moment you're the secretary of DCWD, and I suppose you'll be meeting a lot of women in your line of work, hindi po ba magiging sagabal sa trabaho mo yun na marami kang makikilalang babae?
It happened, Mr. Chair, Your Honor, when I was younger, when I was in the media. And as you grow old, you notice that you start to look differently in life, your perspective, Your Honor, Mr. Chair. When we are young, sir, we make mistakes.
CA members also sought clarification over Tulfo's citizenship since he served in the United States Army as an enlisted personnel from 1988 to 1992. Documents were also presented showing Tulfo serving in Europe from 1992 to 1996. At this point, Tulfo asked for a closed-door session.
What is the status of your citizenship when you were enlisted member of the U.S. Army, and when you serve as an active military service station in Europe?
I would like to ask for an executive session on this matter.
It's not just the issue of citizenship. A CA member also raised Tulfo's conviction of 3 counts of libel already upheld by the Supreme Court.
I was compelled by the court to divulge my sources, but I did not. So it went all the way up to the Court of Appeals and to the Supreme Court, Your Honor, Mr. Chair. It's one of the hazards of the trade.
As the Supreme Court enunciated in several cases, Mr. Chair, libel is an offense that involves moral turpitude. And in some other cases disposed by the Supreme Court, there were certain people who were disqualified from holding positions because they have been convicted of crimes involving moral turpitude.
Tulfo says he requested an executive session so he could answer questions about his citizenship and libel case more freely. He notes he became an American citizen between 1986 to 1988 and renounced his American citizenship just this year. But for Senator Francis Escudero, Tulfo's libel conviction should not be used against him, since there are pending bills in both houses of Congress that seek to decriminalize libel.
This would be taken against the nominee. And later on, that bill is approved by Congress. I think it would be prejudicial, to say the least, and unfair if he would be taking that against him.
The executive session took only an hour, and the decision was to defer Tulfo's ad interim appointment. Tulfo says he is ready to accept the CA's decision.
I brought the documents with me. I know that they'll be asking it. Like, I'm prepared.
It's part of life, I guess. I mean, it's in their hands. I mean, the decision will be in their hands.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.